call of Sister Teresa from the Daughter of Charity. She'll be handling the opening prayer first. Thank you. Are we all right, please? Pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We thank you, precious Father, for the gift of this day. We thank you for counting us worthy to be used as the instruments to fight this menace that has befallen our society. We know that we cannot achieve anything positive without your help, and therefore we ask for the grace of your Holy Spirit what you demand of us, and the grace also to accomplish it. Bless each and every one of us here, and bless those who are still on their way, that we together may join hands to fight this evil and rescue your children, especially those who are still being held captive. These and other blessings we ask through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Sister Teresa. Next on the program, we have the national anthem. So please, can we remain standing for the national anthem? Thank you.
We also have the second speaker here, Reverend Coco Presto. She's also the South coordinator for ASOHON partners, that's the Association of Home Operators in Nigeria. Welcome, madam. Please to the high table, welcome. Round of applause, please.
Can it be to recognize the ED of Handmade Homes, Ambassador Chief Dr. Grace Bokpara, that's one of our big partners too. Also recognizing Sister Teresa from Daughter of Charities who took the opening prayer. Permit me to welcome to the high table Mrs. Gloria Amakiri from the Ministry of Women Affairs. She's here representing the Permanent Secretary. Round of applause, please. Permanent Secretary, Barrister Uchechukwu Uriri, is being represented by Mrs. Gloria Amakiri. Welcome, madam. Welcome everybody present. It won't be complete if I don't recognize the officers of NAPTIP who are here, officers and men. Here we have two ICs with the River State Commander, Mr. Odumkodu Victor, NAPTIP Chief Intelligence Officer. Round of applause, please. Next to him is Mrs. Ebe Simeon Ebe Winifred, NAPTIP Chief Intelligence Officer. These are our high-ranking officers in the command. We also have Mrs. Comfort Udovia, NAPTIP Assistant Chief Intelligence Officer. Permit me to introduce myself. Joy Anna, NAPTIP Principal Intelligence Officer. Next to me, you have Mr. Kumani Timi, NAPTIP Principal Intelligence Assistant. Next to him, we have Osasere. This one, you know, I'm able to pronounce it. NAPTIP Intelligence Officer, too. Next to him, we have Bomane of Masoye, NAPTIP Intelligence Officer. One of the officers seated outside, we have Unis of Parachi, NAPTIP Intelligence Officer. Here we have Osim Edna, NAPTIP Intelligence Officer. Next to Edna, we have Onyeze Chineze, NAPTIP Higher Intelligence Assistant. We also have one of the officers out. They do Ledo Beauty, NAPTIP Higher Intelligence Assistant. Next to her, we have Anne Obey, NAPTIP Intelligence Assistant. And lastly, but not the least, we have Vincent Wadike, NAPTIP Assistant Detective Officer. Thank you all for your presence and thank you for coming on time. I'm going to do a brief introduction. I welcome all of the high table. I would also like to invite the River State Commander, Barrister Nwabaka Ikeliashi, to the high table while she waits for the rest of the guests coming. Thank you. Today we are
starting up the 1 week program to mark the World Day Against Trafficking in Persons. World Day Against Trafficking in Persons comes up every 30th of July each year. That's the UNODC has appointed that day for the World Day Against Trafficking in Persons. Normally, River State Command will always do a roadblock to mark this event, but this year, under the supervision of Barrister Wabata, we decided to do something grand, which is a 1 week program, starting off today with a symposium on Friday. Sensitizing about one mosque. On Sunday the 28th, we'll be sensitizing St. Raphael's Catholic Church at Ebeka Road, Rukoku, and the Anglican Church at Woji. On Tuesday, to wrap up Tuesday the 30th of July, which is the main day for the National World Day Against Human Trafficking, we're going to have a road walk, and it's commencing from Isikoro Park to the River State Ministry of Justice, where the NACTIC office is located on the third floor. Thank you. Please clap for me. With all due respect, permit me to welcome the River State Commander, Barrister Wabaka Ikeziashi, to deliver her welcome address. Thank you. Of slavery
so many years after his death. Millions of people are still tricked or forced from their homes to be exploited and abused. It is estimated that over 2.5 million are recruited, entrapped, transported and exploited in forced labor as a result of trafficking within Nigeria and beyond. This trade, in all its many forms, nets an estimated $32 billion each year for the traffickers, according to the United Nations. And time again, it is the female voices we hear. This should be no surprise. Women and children, of course, make up the overwhelming majority of victims trafficked for sex and forced labor. A recent investigation and report by the Punch newspaper shows the heartbreaking fate of hundreds of Nigerian girls, some under the age of 13, brought to the UK where their dreams of better life ended in brothels. But women and children are also the majority, according to the International Labour Organization, of those economically exploited in other ways, with organ harvesting, sexual exploitation, forced labor, and domestic servants. Trafficking like poverty, discrimination, and abuse of human rights wears a human face indeed. They are strongly related. It is the prejudice which women face in many parts of the state, their lack of rights and control over their own lives, which help create a condition where trafficking can flourish. Women and children are the key targets of traffickers, exactly because of their marginalization, vulnerable states, their poverty, and their exclusion from education and employment opportunity. This is why we must see the urgent need to step up efforts to combat human trafficking as a wider battle for human rights and those in particular for women and children, and why both men and women suffer from this denial of the basic dignity of life. The facts show that women are particularly and badly trafficked. Gender gaps vary from place to place, but the overall pattern of women and children disadvantage remains clear, and women and children around Nigeria knows it. It is a sad fact that the research has found out that the majority of girls, women and children trafficked into Europe, they are abused as children, either by their families or by their local communities. Finally, my esteemed guests, if we must succeed in this fight against human trafficking, it must be a collective effort of the security agents, traditional rulers, governmental and non-governmental organizations. I want to use this opportunity to appreciate the committee of this year's World Against Trafficking in Persons and also the Rotary Club of Cosmopolitan for their relentless efforts in making sure that this event is a success. Thank you all and enjoy the rest of the program. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Commander River State Command, NACTIC. Permit me to recognize the presence of NSCDC, the Nigeria Security and Civil Defense Corps, the State Commandant, BC Igwebwe, is being represented by Superintendent Baharu Grace. A round of applause as she walks to the high table, even though she says she's okay where she is. And please kindly help her to the high table. We don't intend to waste time today, so we'll continue with the program. Next on the program of activities, we have goodwill messages. First presenter for the goodwill message is the 8th sworn-in president for Rotary Club of Port Harcourt Cosmopolitan, Dr. Yvonne Iwo Brown. Permit me to invite her to the program, please. Thank you.
Good morning, Rap Team Commander, officers in there. Good morning, our guests, our fellow Rotarians, and Rotary actors here present. It is my pleasure to stand before you representing my dear club and Rotary at large. My name is Yvonne O. Brown, the 2024-2025 president of Port Harcourt Cosmopolitan, the All CEOs Club. The mission of Rotary Foundation is to enable Rotary members to advance world good understanding, goodwill, and peace through the improvement of health, the support of education, and the alleviation of poverty. The foundation is not for profit, corporation supported solely by voluntary contributions by Rotarians and Friends of Rotary. The foundation has seven areas of focus: peace building, maternal and child care, education and literacy, environmental sustainability. And this today we're here to discuss child trafficking in prison. And the theme for this year is Leave No Child Behind, which is under one of our key areas of focus, maternal and child care, and also peace building. As is often known, that most trafficked children are used for crime. Rotary is committed to bring about lasting and positive changes in our communities and communities around the world. We're here today in collaboration with NATI on a week-long activity in recognition of the World Day Against Trafficking in Persons. Like I stated, today, this symposium, sensitization in churches and the mosque, and then the work, as earlier stated. This year, global campaign, World Day Against Trafficking in Person, urges accelerated action to end child trafficking. Children represent a large proportion of people trafficked worldwide. The girls being disproportionately affected. One in three women trafficked persons globally is a child. Additionally, children are twice as likely to face violence during trafficking than adults, according to the UNODC's global report on trafficking in persons. Amid overlapping crises such as armed conflict, pandemics, economic hardship, and environmental challenges, children are increasingly vulnerable to trafficking. Furthermore, online platforms pose additional risks to children, when children often connect without adequate safeguards. Children are subjected to various forms of trafficking, including exploitation in forced labor, criminality, begging, illegal adoption, recruitment into armed force, and online and sexual exploitation. To date, we have not effectively addressed the issue of child trafficking. This must change. Urgent and comprehensive action is essential to tackle this dire situation, to protect the vulnerable groups from exploitation. There is need for support of child victims of trafficking. To effectively combat this scourge, considered efforts are needed at both international and national levels. States must prioritize child protection, bolster legislation, improve law enforcement, and allocate more resources to combat child trafficking. Prevention efforts should target root causes like poverty and inequality to reduce children's vulnerability. Special attention must be paid to trafficking of children on the move. strengthening child protection systems and implementing child-sensitive justice system are crucial for supporting victims and holding perpetrators accountable. Civil society organizations, the private sector, and communities have a vital role in raising awareness, providing support, services, and advocating for policy reforms. So I call every one of us here today to lend our voices, to lend our hands in the fight against trafficking and oppression. Thank you.
Thank you. That is the president of Rotary Cosmopolitan, Rotary Club of Nigeria Cosmopolitan. Yeah, for the birthday with us this year to make this event shine the way it is. We are grateful, and I want to use this opportunity to say thank you to every Rotary Club of Port Harcourt Cosmopolitan member right here. From time to time, I get to represent my boss at their meetings, and they're so welcoming, they're so loving. And when you get there, it's home away from home. I appreciate you so much. So today I'm going to steal one of your songs, yes, and I'm not paying money to sing it, because you must pay for every song. We love you. We love you. Child. Thank you very much. So next, for the goodwill message, I'd like to invite the representative from the Nigeria Security and Civil Defense Corps to give us just a short talk. I know you aren't ready for this because your commandant was actually supposed to do that, but and be gracious with your pretty face. Thank you very much. A round of applause, please. Superintendent Bahago Grace, welcome.
Good morning, everyone. Please permit me to stand on the existing protocol. My name is Bahago Grace, a representative from Nigerian Security and Civil Defense Corps, River State Command. I'm here to present my state commandant. And I bring you greetings from him. And instead, I should let you know that Civil Defense is also an agency that supports the fight against human trafficking. And that we are always open for information, any credible information about child trafficking or any form of human trafficking, any form of trafficking. So we're going to act swiftly towards that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I didn't pronounce the name well. I said Bahago Grace. And she said, Superintendent Bahago Grace. So, thank you very much, Superintendent Bahago Grace.
A round of applause, please.
It's not easy to sit with your picture on this day in Nigeria. Next, we have Mrs. Gloria Amakiri, representing the Permanent Secretary for the Ministry of Women and Affairs. Kindly give her a round of applause as she walks up this way. Welcome, Madam. So a little story. Madam Gloria did not know she was coming here today. She just called her and said, go to that place and represent me. And when your boss says goes, go. You go without asking questions. You're welcome, Madam.
Good morning, all. Mrs. Gloria Adamakri, representing the Ministry of Women Affairs, the Permanent Secretary, is Barrister Uche Uhure. I bring greetings from her and apologies. She really, really wants to be here, but something comes up. You know, we have boss and we have bosses. So the commissioner has sent her somewhere and she has to send me to this place. But I'm on my way to the clinic when she called me. So we, the Ministry of Women Affairs, thanking the organizers of this program, because we are against the trafficking of a child. So we are one of you people. Whatever you are doing, we are with you people. We join our hands together with you to stop this child trafficking, both in the state and to the nation. So we move forward as we look up to leave no child behind the fight against human trafficking. In our office too, they come with them, we tackle the matters. The one we cannot do, we take it to FIDA. The one we can handle, we handle it. We arrest. We have lawyers in our office to tackle them. So we thank all of you. We are behind this program from the beginning to the end. So thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you so much.
So I introduce her as Mrs. Gloria Amakiri. Permit me to make the correction. Mrs. Gloria Dada Amakiri. You're welcome.
Next, I would like to invite our keynote speaker of the 2014, which is Leave No Child Behind in the Fight Against Human Trafficking, Associate Professor Daniel Uranta, who is the head of Department for Social Service, Social Works from the University of Port Harcourt. Kindly give him a round of applause that he walks with you, please. About representing your voice in different places is that you get to meet big people, and even when you are becoming on your own. Prof is one person that when he comes into the office, he lights up everywhere. He's a very cheerful fellow and a jolly good fellow too. Whenever Prof comes around, everybody is smiling, even if the work is pressing your neck, you know. But we are happy to have you here, sir. Prof was among the first people to come here, which means he's very time conscious. Thank you, sir. We appreciate you. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you so much for having me. Yes, sir. Can I have the slides for this lecture? The slide. Good morning, everybody. This is a lead address presented by my humble self, Daniel Uranta, head of the Department of Social. Against trafficking in person at
and manage conference for the people of Boston University. My name is Alabre, social worker faculty. The project was mainly established in our city. As I told you now, we're all under the idea of social workers. We have PDG, we have mass and work here in social work. That is all the practice under the head of the leadership of the school. So the topic given to me to discuss or to harvest is giving a child in the fight against human trafficking. It gives me great pleasure to deliver this key address to these great men and women who are assembled here today for this great occasion. I have associated with this command, they know, I'll deal with it. In fact, the Department of Social Work, Professor Potato, has benefited blessing from the outfit through the collaborative activities. Sincerely, I appreciate them for this invitation. For today, we celebrate the World Day Against Trafficking in Persons, which is 2024. In addressing this team assigned to me for explication, I would like to, first of all, consider the subject matter in twofold, namely human trafficking and the child, which have capital focus in this enterprise. I really want to, where is the chairman? I really want to pause there to really apologize. My students ought to be here, the postgraduate students. They want to be here. I think there are some people will be on their way, they'll be here. And so we have joint partnership students to knock them for field work. We don't have an idea of what is happening inside. So that they too will be a victim. So I said, our students for field work in particular. So they have always been our hand to assist them. So we partner and the university, we can also have do some things like this, public lecture or research for the body. Whenever they call us, we will be at the poster. Okay, since we cannot have anything, it's going to be the ministry. We don't have the slide. So introduction, what is human trafficking? What is human trafficking? And that's why we're here. Human trafficking is a form of modern day slavery. That's what I've explained. That's what I've explained by my friends and colleagues. It's a modern day slavery that involves the illegal trading of people for exploitation and for commercial gain. It is relatively recent. Then used to describe the act of acquisition or transportation of a person away from the community in which they live through the use of force, coercion, or deception for the purpose of exploiting them. Ibrahim, Omeregbe, 2020. So they said that in the case of children, who are the vulnerable, the coercion will not be needed for their children. I put the word of United Nations Organization, 2023, it says human trafficking is the recruitment, transportation, transfer, harboring, or receipt of persons by means of threat or use of force or other form of coercion. Of adoption, of fraud, of deception, of abuse of power, or a position of vulnerability, or the giving or receiving of payment or benefit to achieve the consent of a person having control over another person for the purpose of exploitation, which I include as minimum which has minimal expression of the prestigious. This is the position of the UNO, United Nations. Every person who is involved, who takes this as a business, has the opportunity to have a motive of making profit. Well, we will look at that later. The importance of this is that trafficking occurs either living within the country Nigeria or internationally through various routes across the geopolitical zones of Nigeria. Nigeria is a source, transit, and destination country for women subjected to trafficking in persons, including forced labor or forced prostitution. The traffic Nigerian women and children are recruited from rural areas, especially rural areas. Within the country borders, women and girls for involuntary domestic servitude and sexual exploitation. And boys are forced laborers in streets, vending, domestic servitude, mining, begging, which is 2018. In fact, the actual destination for trafficking Nigerian child vary depending on the purpose of their exploitation. Uche 2018, Uche 2018 maintained that the most female victims in Italy are the most prepared target from Nigerians. So very to do this. For those that were not able to reach Europe, end up being trapped in North Africa.
You know, I live in India, we have a very special Sahara Desert. If we are able to live there, you can see what's happening on that Sahara Desert. People are moving in trenches, in room, all of what they are in traffic. So they are being trapped.
In portraying this fact, okay, through 2007, the estimate by the Italian authorities portray about 1,000 Nigerians, prostitutes, who live in Italy.
These are such issues. It's not just a saying, it's not just a saying. Verifiable facts.
Other countries such as Netherlands, Saudi Arabia, Belgium, Australia, Canada, Spain, Lebanon, Germany, and some of the destinations too.
Okoje, and others, additional 2014.
Even mention Africa, children are also trafficked to Côte d'Ivoire, South Africa, Togo, Guinea, Mali, Burkina Faso, Sierra Leone. Niger, they are born in Liberia, in 2006. Cali, in 2006.
Our children and our brothers and sisters have been transferred to this neighborhood here. When they cross the border, and inside the Capernaum waters, they are about.
Now, we need to know the type of trafficking. Types. One, the child labor.
And child labor, what does it mean?
It means employment of children in any work that deprives children of their childhoodness. Interferes with their ability to attend regular activities and as such, deny them of their rights.
That's child labor.
Two, child sex trafficking. Many of these children are linked or sold or kidnapped for ritual purposes and sexual expressions in hotels, nightclubs, used for massaging, you find the massage parlors and sex dolls.
For all the parents,
our children. If our children are forced into drug addiction, unwanted pregnancy, malnutrition, and social altruism, the resistance eventually will lead to death.
This is what I've seen, observed, and research. If you don't believe, we'll kill you there. It's now somewhere.
And the government will say that
for ritual poses, and other harvesting, all sorts of things, light things, not to respect. And we get that phone to hold our hands and watch what has been happening in our country. What about that phone? It can be a child. Then tell me, don't assume whatever. Don't forget. Debt, bondage. Now, people are the type of trafficking pattern. Debt, bondage. Bounded levels is similar to slavery because it involves a debt that cannot be paid off in a reasonable time. Involuntary domestic servitude. This occurs when a domestic worker becomes ensnared in an exploitative situation where he or she is unable to escape. Now, look at the agents of this Africa. The traffickers, the agents, who are they? We call them traffickers. They refer to recruiters as well as transporters, receivers, brothel keepers, corrupt border guys. You know, some of these are security men there. You see what they do at the border. They quit this one. It's called the name of Ashu. I think that will help us. And producers of false documentation, all who benefit from the duty or pass through their hands. A very small matter. The traffic victim. These are all men and women, children who are deceived, transported, and delivered into the hands of those who exploited them for profit and business. This is what we can do of them, these traffic victims. And the traffickers. Now look at the other factor, pull factors of human trafficking. What about pull factors? What are the driving force that led to impact on this? Well, here I say number one is a lack of employment. The problem in Nigeria is a village. The more you do, the less you see. I don't know. Well, that should not make them to impact on this project of the human being, a person, or a student, maybe. All creatures of God. Poor political economy. Yeah, what I mean by this, political economy, it's just that the ruling class determines the economy. The ruling class in every country determines the economy of that country. So we combine the politics and the economy. We say political economy affect our discussion on the topic because most of the policies our politicians will take or they take always affect the smooth run of government, our political beings. Most of the policies. You know the policies, it's not the part of the discussion, but the policies, political economy, the value of money, the business, low self-esteem is another issue. Some people condemn themselves, they are not going to do that, this and that. The search for greener pasture is another factor. The search for greener pasture. Then the high level of poverty is another issue. Some people can't meet anything, they can't get something to eat. They live from hand to mouth. How do we help us in this case? Mode of operations. How do you operate? How do you operate? Mode of operations. Human trafficking is when people are brought or move around the country and forced to work or do other things that they don't want to do. Your right, the pride, the privilege is gone. They force you to do what they want you to do. Traffickers use violence, strength, or false promises of well-paid job. That's why we want to bring our children here, and the students. Because they will tell you, Java, all is well. Java, you get a good job there. You go there, they will give me your passport. Give me a what? Your visa. Don't you know that I brought you here? And the business will start. God will help us. I said, God will help us. They use violence, strength, and better life to trick victims into working for them. That is not
I just go to a white man country, a black one. That's how we'll be looking at you when I see the picture. Everyone who promises you go to that place, you go to that place, not you. But that's what, that's their beginning, which is also a modern symbol. What should be our role as families, parents, and guardians in leaving no child in the fight against human trafficking? Again, in assessing this, one can ask, who is a child? Who is a child? Because the only one you need a child can know what to do. And so in this context, you say a child is a young person or young woman being below the age of poverty or below the legal age of maturity. Or a young person, especially below infancy and poverty. For the purpose of the discourse, a child means every human being below the age of 18 years, unless under the law applicable to the child. Majority is attained. Now, let me speak of this. Depending on the cultural disposition of that country, let alone have the constitution. In our Nigeria, you can say every child from year 1 or 0 year or less year 1 to 70 years is a child. I hope we agree with you. Other child like acts. But even within that, we have adolescents, we have teenagers. So you have to be real child. And so anymore, whatever you are doing to any child, between 17 to you are just want to show that will comment. But that child belongs to comment. When the child is off the hook, it's when the child is above 17 years, from 18 years up. It can be footage, and they're pointed and bent. If it's an adult, it can take care of himself. And so it's good to understand this definition of everyone who's a child. Child cannot take this on himself. He should be careful. He should go down and see what's happening. Effect of human trafficking. The trafficking persons often experience anxiety, depression, isolation, aggressive feelings, or behavior, self-stigmatization, or perceived stigmatization through others. Difficulty in accessing necessary resources. That's the effect. A child or woman that has been arrested or maybe handed over. What should be the status of the persons and what I've said? Depression, anxiety, emotions. The goodified Child Rights Act. Let me come back to China again. Children's rights are enormous. They are protected and as listed above, right to survival, right to thoughts, right for private and family life, right to freedom and of movement, right to leisure, recreation, cultural activities, right to health and health services, right for education, protection, maintenance, rights to free, compulsory university education, primary education, and so on, etc. Right of a child in need of special protection measures. Right of the unborn child to protection against harm and child. You can see unborn child had also protection. So you don't abort her anyhow. Apart from the above measures, the River State Government has put in place a document called Official Gazette 2022, which seeks the holistic protection of a child in the following areas. One, protection of a child, the right of a child as published in the right act 23, prohibition of prohibit child marriage. You know this happened in this country now. You know this one, we're hiding it. It's prevalent, it's cultural to certain people, certain religion. It's against child right now. Do we enforce it? Do we implement it? It's a challenge. Prohibition of child betrothal, punishment of a child for marriage, for not giving the consent of marriage, prohibition of a male genital mutilation, exposure to use, production, and trafficking of narcotic drugs, use of children in other criminal activities, abduction, removal, and transfer from lawful custody, child that level, prohibition of its prohibitive level, application of level acts. Prohibition of buying and selling.
Some of people are thinking of this issue of
credit factory. Credit factory. Well, these people are going to give back the payment and they sell. And they sell and make money.
Who knows? We are aware. We are aware of that. We need the Department of Social Work. We find out about that. That the children are bought with money and then give it to somebody. At high price. This should be extinguished. It's humanism, dehumanism. I can't see that anybody before. God will help us. I am one of us dealing in children for the purpose of hawking or begging for arms and prostitution.
The service we are having is of course the fear, especially what is happening to some people who are even legislators, Abuja and that. When they want to go for a set, they want to go for a picnic, these young girls, they will take. Young girls, especially of students in the one, they want to take hotels. And it's fair. All the way possible. Unlawful sexual intercourse with a child. What about that? Form of sexual abuse and exploitation. Prohibition of recruitment of children into armed forces. Among others, the Gazette has provided protection of children, child assessment orders, emergency protection orders, duration of emergency protection orders, children taken to police custody. Confiscation, case of emergency, duty of the state government to investigate the schools, whereabouts of children who may be in need of emergency protection. These are the protections that are in place. To help NACTEC, to help those who are the protection check protection agency on networking, to ensure that our children are not just kept like that, but kept in the hand of the enemies. The importance of their goal, the role of social workers. We partner with them, social work professionals. We have what we call chapter of social work here. We are a fellow, and the fellow, and the special case of God, we are licensed. We are legal entity. So we follow up on how many cases do. So we work in partnership with that actor. Sometimes I refer cases to them. Sometimes we invite them to the history. And so, what do social workers do? To talk with clients. For example, if you have a client who also has been attacking, they need to be rehabilitated, bring back to normal life, or they say they need to be brought back to normal life, right? Where they have been, or what it should be. So it's a work of social workers to help, to assist for psychological problems and psychosocial problems, trauma and post-traumas. Who now do that? Ensure that they are brought back to normal life with the water, with the way they want to be met. They can help educate the greater communities of the warning signals of victimization behavior. Involve themselves in greater community effort, and they can also force the social work perspective to politicians, lawmakers who make choices about finding programs for those most vulnerable to victimization, such as homeless, immigrants, unprotected children, and to victimizing such as disenfranchised groups, those lacking strong supportive family structures, and the financially and emotionally undesirable. They should help these people out to become something. That's what the social worker do. They bridge the gap to advise, to go for home visit, to counsel, provide direct support to those victimized through advocacy, psych education, and clinical interventions. Provide support to victims regarding reintegration of society. This involves the establishment of a national abuse hotline so that people can report any intervention as well as provision of sound education, which should be free of possible for every Nigerian child. So professor, our children are suffering a lot in education. They can't do their schools. Let me put the glass. A glass of 150. We have 20 students to teach. They can't do the transport to go to class. What's happening? The hardship is vital. So how will they do? We'll give them an example. We'll test them. And then we'll go to go have them. And so there's also the need for government to come up with a design system for surveillance. Surveillance and coordinating health of traffic persons, including establishing whistleblower. I would advise the local authority to look at the way to engage new whistleblowers. Of course, we are there for them, we'll assist at our own environment. But they should start to consider that when you see those people who are attracting the children, you give report to the captain immediately. I know they will act. Well, the fact of the chairman will have is an active chairman. He's an active chairman. I just appreciate that. Give her the call, she'll speak up immediately. So, whistleblower is here in the one day. Indicating the community to service providers about the need of those victimized and promoting for infrastructure and funding for intervention and treatment programs. Conclusion. If the above are well implemented effectively, nobody will be able to leave any child or trafficking. Additionally, just as it was mentioned above, the role of whistleblower cannot be well emphasized. For effective action, all hands must be on deck through collaboration, networking, teamwork, collectivity, and social inclusivity, and the desired goal of protecting our children from human trafficking will be achieved to a large extent. I wish all good, positive, fruitful contribution in this social integration. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Associate Professor Daniel Reiter of the University of Port Harcourt. While the prof was giving his wonderful speech on the theme for the 2024 World Day Against Human Trafficking, some special people walked in. I would like to recognize the presence of International Women Federation, International Federation of Women Lawyers, IFWLW. Please a round of applause. These are always looking very pretty. African Women Lawyers Association, AULA, is our big partner too. Permit me to also recognize the presence of Greater Women Initiative for Health and Rights. Those are our partners too. They have the homes where we keep our victims when we rescue them. I just noticed someone on the high table that I didn't conclude on her portfolio. The ED of DBI, you know when she wants to introduce herself, anyway, when it's her turn, she'll introduce herself. Let me not spoil the introduction. You will hear titles for this from this national, state, grassroots. Anyway, you get there. Please let me have my glasses. I would like to also recognize the presence of Center for Justice, partners too. Center for Justice, please. A round of applause, please. Please let's make them feel welcome, because you are actually welcome. So after the keynote speaker, we're supposed to have presentation of short stories on human trafficking, narrative drama. Well, permit me to steal some time to recognize the presence of one of our wonderful people, Rotary. He is chartered president of Rotary Club of Port Harcourt, Cosmopolitan. President, you didn't put the name. You know me, I like to call on this. Okay. So now I don't want to be correcting myself. Um,
Yes, let me rewind you so that it's slow. Chapter President of Rotary Club of Port Harcourt Cosmopolitan. You know that Cosmopolitan, I hear you roll your tongue. Cosmopolitan. Dr. Innocent Iyala Harry. A round of applause, please. I understand that Doc has something to present for us, sir. Do you have anything you want to present for us, or do you want to transfer it to the person who is going to be speaking on behalf of? Sir, please, when Doc is talking, please, people will have to listen very well. This is another section of diction. Please, let's just hear your voice, even if you don't have anything to say to us. Let's just hear your voice. Welcome, sir. Round of applause, please. Okay, I also like to welcome the representative of the Solicitor General, River State, NACTAL. NACTAL is the Network Against Child Trafficking, Abuse and Labor. That one will come out in the exam, so I must wait. Welcome, Doug. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Collaborators, NAP team. This is very important for us in Rotary. The Minister of Child Trafficking across national frontiers. You don't know the magnitude of it until you at least get it.
And we are going to, both as Rotary and
through the network of the African Union that we have advocated for, to help to put this dreadful encounter to rest. We're not going to rest on that part because there is an incredible business, and you'll find very strong people too. If you see the Morocco caravan, or the Mali caravan, or the Cote d'Ivoire caravan, these are all caravans that do trans-Saharan trade. I think they're dealing in spices and no, these are human beings. And honestly, it is very heartbreaking. I commend all of you who have come here today, and I speak to other voices today. And hopefully, at the end, we shall come up with something that makes very much sense. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Joe.
Thank you. You can treat these ones and make yourself comfortable while you wait for them. Malta is a long distance in rural community, and our partners are the Nigerian Police Force are fully on alert. We are so sorry for his name.
Madam, he talked on us as well, but justice must prevail. We will make sure your daughter and others must be brought back.
Thank you. Thank you. Defense Corps (NSADC), rated an apprehended member of the Human Trafficking Syndicate, which specializes in organ harvesting at the Enugu area of Lagos and rescued 10 potential victims of human trafficking. Investigations revealed that this particular group targeted young healthy Nigerians who they lured with promises of forced contracts and jobs abroad. The 10 rescued victims fit this profile. Their plan was to harvest the organs at destination countries. However, the syndicate operations as they planned by the Nigerian Immigration Service (NIS), they could not procure international passport for the 10 victims for trafficking to traffic them abroad, and they resorted to harvesting their organs within the country. The arrest of the syndicate was as a result of the credible intelligence sharing, effective synergy with all relevant law enforcement agencies, and technology-driven investigation. We assure Nigerians of the federal government's commitment to the effective tackling of the activities of human traffickers, and also be assured of the dedication of NAPC and other sister law enforcement agencies to this fight.
To nominate tonight, 7 out of 13 victims of kidnapping or harassment, 10 of the rescued might be having killed. The survivors were found in a careless health condition at the point of their rescue, but are currently receiving medical attention at an undisclosed hospital. I'm Jason Newman, the PR of the National Agency for Human Trafficking in person, NAPC, hinted that investigations are ongoing and all perpetrators were prosecuted under Section 20 to trafficking in persons, prohibition, enforcement, and administration act. For so more of it, the news is the trafficking of persons.
I don't blame for life. I don't blame for life. Thank you, Lord. I want to thank you, Lord.
Thank you, my Lord. At this junction, I would like to begin by saying that from the totality of evidence presented before the Honorable Court, it is quite obvious that the prosecution has proven its case against the defendant beyond reasonable doubt. But I want you, my Lord, to so hold and convince them accordingly. Where is the junction?
Thank you. You have heard what the prosecution counsel just said. Any other questions?
My Lord, given the evidence presented before this honorable court against my client, the defendant, and your lordship accepting the case, I hereby pray that you temper justice with mercy, considering the fact that they are false offenders. And as you can see, my Lord, they are very remorseful. One of the women is presently pregnant, and the men are family men with faith spirit. I hope for this, my Lord. Thank you.
The court shall rise and come back to heaven.
Court!
The defense and the prosecution counsel, this is the judgment of the court. The defendant, Mr. Mondi Ibibi, and 8 others brought before this honorable court on a 7-count charge on Section 20 of the Trafficking in Persons Provision Enforcement and Administration Act 2016. Based on the overwhelming evidence, this court hereby finds the defendant guilty of all alleged crimes of procurement and recruitment of persons for the sole purpose of organ harvesting. They are hereby sentenced to 15 years imprisonment each on the first prison and 9 years each on the other 4 counts, which shall run concurrently. I told you.
Thank you.
home studio, and we are going to Nollywood soon. It will please you to know that everyone who acted in this are all NASA staff, from Ida Lagos or Abuja Command. So we don't intend to waste too much time, so we'd like to continue with the event. I hope the event is not boring you, because we don't hold video without popcorn, so bear with us. So permit me to just complete the donors. We have Global Link Partners, we have Grace Events Limited, we have Maybelline Consult, we have Intercontinental Distillers, and then we have Mr. Simeon Eden. Those are the people that also contributed to the beauty of this event. We say thank you very much to them, and may God bless them in Jesus' mighty name. So to go further, my glasses are changed. Okay, the president of Rotary Cosmopolitan, Dr. Ewo Brown, has told me to announce that we have the red cards and the program in the book, in the notebooks that have been shared, because some people, she just found out she had that. You know, I'm sure she was wondering how come she didn't get a program. So kindly share with me. The red card is, you know, when you're playing a football match and you give a player red card, it means it's over. You need to leave the field. And I think there's suspension for maybe one or two more games or so. But when you see the red card and you see stop human trafficking, NACTIC is kicking out human trafficking from Rivers State and Nigeria, West Africa, and the world. So when we go for the photo session downstairs, kindly go down to your red card, please, because we are going to raise up the red card to kick out human trafficking from Nigeria. Thank you. I would like to welcome the second speaker. Remember that thing I told you about titles? I want to be able to say, but I think it's hard to please introduce herself the way I know she usually does. I'd like to call the second speaker for today, Rotaract Coco Presto. Now, Rotaract Coco, she's giving us double barrel in the sense that she's also the South coordinator for ASOHON, Association of Home Operators in Nigeria, and then she's also a Rotaract and of the Cosmopolitan River State, Rotary Club of Port Harcourt. So I'll employ you to please clap as she comes to the podium. And I also advise, I don't know, maybe before you become a Rotaract, maybe I want to join very soon. I'll still have to go for classes, for diction classes. Maybe my kids will put me through. But if you can't speak well with your diction, I think it's part of what they used to take members of. Even the broken English is sounding. Let her just speak. Welcome.
I didn't come out with my glasses, my reading glasses. It's going to be a very big issue here, but I'll try. You know, in Rotary, we're very official, so I'm going to
Rotary.
We're very official. The Rotary president, Neil Brown, the ultimate charter president. We call him PJ, Innocent Iyala.
Hi.
Thank you. Fellow Rotarians and friends of Rotary. I would also like to welcome the FIDA representatives and AULA, the NACTIC River State Commander, the PS, Ministry of Justice, the representative from the Minister of Women Affairs. I think there are NGO networks here as well. Friends and guests, I didn't come to do the paper presentation. I came to stir up action against child trafficking. I hardly even know where to start from. but somehow I was involved in a case where two babies died. And the story turned. The case eventually went to court. I had no inkling where the children came from. My role was to care and protect. But the case turned. And the media reported differently. I took the issue as the cross I had to bear for caring for children. I was accused of selling two children for 3 million naira. However, the traffickers were in court, and I wasn't the trafficker. I was the person who cared for the children, and I was named the trafficker by the media. 2 years after that case, the traffickers are still in court. The baby's not yet buried. I don't know what has happened now, because I actually stopped going to court. I have no business going to court anymore. However, nobody said anything to me thereafter. But like I said, I took it as the cross I had to bear for caring for children. Leaving no child behind is a standard we must create. First of all, I stand here as the Rotary Youth Chair for the Rotary Club of Port Harcourt Cosmopolitan. And I also stand here as the South-South Coordinator for the Association of Homes and Orphanages in Nigeria. And I promised myself that I was never going to let any child trafficking case go unpunished because of what I have gone through. According to the latest global estimate by UNICEF, over 150 million children are subjected to child labor, with nearly half in hazardous forms of work. Human trafficking is the second largest criminal industry worldwide. One in four victims of modern day slavery are children and are mostly girls living in this modern day slavery. So thinking of how to stop human trafficking can really be overwhelming. And I really want to give credit to FIDA. They don't sleep. I want to quickly remind us about a famous quote by Martin Luther, which says that our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter. This one matter. And I thank my club, the Rotary Club of Port Harcourt Cosmopolitan, for partnering with NACTIP to do this. When I came into the hall, I told the commandant, I said, I don't like the fact that this hall is empty. I didn't want you to just go with your partners, with your stakeholders. I wanted to see schools. I wanted to see market women. I wanted to see women association, churches. I wanted to see the public in there. I wanted to see children, the people we are fighting for, the youth, the young girls. Or even, if possible, go to the profiles where the 14-year-olds are. Bring them out here and talk to them. The ones who are waiting for their passports to be ready.
I wanted to come in here and see a woman crying at a nanny until my child is released to me. It is not just about stakeholders. I didn't come to make a paper presentation. I'm sorry. The issue is strong. It is becoming bigger. That industry, if we are not careful, will overwhelm us. They live amongst us, the syndicates. The parents, they live amongst us. Why are they not here? I wanted to see that. And I pray that in the next time you're holding a thing like this, let's expand the horizon. Let's think out of the box. Let's not just work with stakeholders. Let's open this event to everybody. How much of the radio jingles did I hear about this event? Who shouldn't hear about this event? Everybody should be in the know. We all should hear about this event. This hall should be filled to the brim and people outside waiting because of this case. The root causes or the reasons why people are end up in a situation of human child trafficking are diverse. It could be poverty, conflict, inequality, absence of viable employment opportunities or social support, and discrimination are among the main reasons for people to seek opportunities abroad. Today, anyone can be a trafficking victim, regardless of ethnicity, nationality, gender, age, or economic status. Human trafficking is now facilitated online. You see those things you see? Free visa to Libya. Free this and free that. Want your children not to be involved. Mommy, I saw something on the internet. They say it's free. Visa application free. This one free. That one free. People come out even openly to talk about packages they will provide for free. And I ask myself, who does that? Who does that? If you're a traveler, if you're an international traveler, you know what it will cost you to pay your agent to facilitate your travel. And then someone will come to the internet and tell you all these things they will do for you free. They will take you to school free. They will pay your flight free. Take you from your village free to Lagos. Who does that? You will pay for it. The child pays for it. Because when they get to where they get to, they collect the passport, they seize the passport from them, they confine them to a room to sleep with dogs, to sleep with horses, to sleep with all sorts of things to raise that money for them. Where are the women that have been affected? That their children at 14 years have been lifted from their communities? Where are they? They should have been there. This is what is going on. And this industry is growing. This is what is going on. Sadly, traffickers are mostly victims' families. My auntie who lives in Lagos came and met my mother and told my mother that she would like me to come and live with her. And the girl goes to Lagos to be with the auntie. And the poor mother calls the auntie, and then, hi, Emeka. Emeka is fine, she's sleeping. I will let her talk to you. Let her talk to you till 2 years after, you will not hear the girl's voice. Families. Why is it that when children are missing, when children are brought, the police comes, we found this child at Malfim. One thing happened here. No parent has gone to the police station to announce that their child is missing. Why? What is going on? The babies that are intercepted by either the police feeder or by a napkin, they were delivered by a mother. Where are the mothers of these babies? How did the babies end up in the hand of the syndicates, the parents? Or even their legal guardian, spouses, and intimate partners who are pimping their friends out. And this exists across continents.
facilitated through a variety of venues. These children who are trafficked are day old most times, get totally abandoned, and I'm speaking from experience. Now, when they find these children at day old, and the child becomes sick at 6 months, and they suddenly realize that this child is HIV positive, the next thing they're looking for is the home to go and abandon that child. I have an abandoned child. I'd like to bring you to the home. Where did this child come from? She can't tell you where the child came from. Only for you to realize the child is HIV positive. And because this child was bought day old, they didn't know the transactions they went into. Now an imbecile, or the child is now autistic, or the child has a cerebral palsy, they do not want to keep the child. The orphanages become the dumping ground. It has always been my prayer that the process of prosecution should be a little faster.
And stricter.
A little faster, please. These people are used to coming to court for too long. And the case go on for too long. I remember after I came out, and they said, you have to be coming to court. And I asked myself, what am I coming to court to do? Because when I come to court to witness what's going on there, they will tell you, if you're a witness to this case, step out. What am I stepping out for? I came to witness a case that you roped me into, and you're telling me to step out. Why do I have to step out? So I stopped going to court. What am I doing here then, if I can't even know what's going on in there? Do you understand? It took too long, and at some point I got tired. I thought I wasn't going anymore.
And the people will still be trafficking.
Yes, I stopped going. So I really want to appeal. I know our legal luminaries are here. I have so much respect for FIDA. I want to pray that someday there will be a Nigeria. The justice system will see the reason why they have to do it really quick and fast. So we take these people off the streets really quickly. I pray. There is also a need to educate and inform people, everyone, about the signs. Parents, inform your children. Signs of trafficking, and also raise awareness in communities. Empower the community, raise awareness. And I really want to thank NAPTIS Public Enlightenment Unit. Thank you for the work you're doing. The police, DSS, FIDA, through your programs aimed at disrupting, combating, and preventing human trafficking, modern slavery, and exploitation of children. But this is not enough. We all need to take ownership of this cause. Everyone. Everyone. Let's go to the communities and conduct sensitization programs. If I walk into Rumosi community, am I going to find a poster there that says, stop child trafficking? Am I going to find this poster there? Are the churches aware, both in the urban and the rural? Are they aware? Are women groups aware? The age grades, targeting the age grade below, are they aware? Can we go back to the drawing table and look out for the youth, the women? What about healthcare workers? What about those ones who say they are healthcare workers who work in mushroom clinics in the communities, and all they do there is deliver babies and exchange them? Oh, please. That's why I said I didn't come to present a paper here. I pray I won't cry. Because these are the people who give these babies out.
They pop these babies out when it's not even their time. They pop these babies out. Do they know about this campaign? Do they know the consequences of what they are doing? Do they know it? Until that is done. What about traditional birth attendants? Those who deliver and then hold the mother's ransom until they sell the babies and bring them their money. Do they know that that act is against the law? We didn't bring them out, but they are very important because this is where most of those young women go to deliver. If they don't deliver with the local nurse, they deliver with traditional birth attendants. So they are all part of it. A young child was brought in by feeder, and after delivery, this child and the mother couldn't pay, who was 18 years, couldn't pay. And the traditional birth attendants asked her and the young man who assisted her to go sell the baby. So they were on their way to Oweri. I don't know if you remember, I think it was 14. They were on their way to Oweri to sell out the baby. They went to the police, intercepted them. And the baby came back to me. The baby is 8 years now. That baby was HIV positive. And it's still HIV positive. Living positive with HIV. Imagine if they succeeded in setting out that child. And the people would have bought that child without knowing what they were buying. It's okay to buy, but know what you're buying. And that child is alive today. The child is alive today. Not sold, because it's not a commodity. The child is for care and protection, not a commodity. So that woman in the community who, what was done to her? She was left here and she wasn't sensitized. Let's go back and do this work. The churches. Most of the traffickers go to church on Sunday. They go to church on Sunday. They're in church. I remember once when I gave a lead to somebody. And you know where the person was arrested? In the church, right in his unit where he was working. Right in his unit, his church unit. I said, come, when you get there, just look for so and so unit. And when they got there, they found him in his unit. And guess the unit? Children's ministry. Yes! Children's Can we take community ownership of this cause? I'm so wrong with that. Don't worry. Let's take ownership to end this process. Let's lead campaigns to schools and colleges. Let's synergize, teamwork. NAPTIN work together with FILA. FILA work together with police work together with DSS work together with all the essential groups, midwives, everybody working together. Civil society, the response team, there's a response team in Rivers. There's a response team. Do they know about the cases you see? Can we set up child protection clubs in schools? Has been in my mind for some time. Can we set up child protection clubs in schools? What about committees? Child protection committees in the communities? Have we thought of ensuring that every school has a child protection and safeguarding policy? Have we thought about that? Producing stickers for cars, posters for everybody's home and offices. Churches everywhere. Can we ensure that every institution
has a copy of the Child Rights Act. The schools, the churches, the cottages, the hospitals, everybody. So that tomorrow you will not say, I did not know. According to the lawyer, they say, ignorance of the law is not an excuse. Can we ensure the homes are not villages? Everybody. Can we act a little faster when these issues arise? I know how many times I've driven into homes that are not registered. And I come in like a visitor and I just talk to you and look around. And I quickly take pictures and send to the ministry. I said, can we look at this? Can we act on this? They act or they don't act, but I've done my work. Can we be a little smarter by responding a little quickly? If I have a phone and I go to a location that I know is a syndicate hideout, I can quickly send my location with a note and run out because I may not be able to talk. Can we act a little smarter? Because I may not be able to talk in that location, I may be killed. So I quickly send my location with a note because I know what's going on in that place, but I may not be able to speak on the phone. I'm rounding up, please. In leaving no child behind, let's ensure that children are not denied their fundamental rights, safety and security, care and protection. Let's create a world where every child grows up free from fear, exploitation, and harm. How to quickly remind us that love and compassion are necessary for our common survival. The strongest thing we have isn't our fists, because most times it's the fists that we use, it's our voice. So let's fight with a renewed commitment to child protection. Let's take action. Thank you.
Also, like to enlighten you that this woman you are are seeing here, it used to be my neighbor once upon a time when I was 14. And I came to Port Harcourt in 2006, fresh from NYSC. I got a job in aviation and I had to stay with family, friends, and married. She was next door. And then I didn't know much about human trafficking. Like I said, it was just prostitution we knew about then. But when you see them calling her, they just found one baby in my womb. She stands up. She didn't know how they got there. You know, she's moving and I'm like, what's going on here? Then weekends, you see children in the compound playing in the house. I'm like, who's that? Is she the woman who delivered all the children? I was going to say, I said, leave there, that's the old boss. Ah, that's her job. And you know, you can imagine that was 2006. This is 2024. In 2 years' time, that is 20 years. And she did not start in 2006. So you can imagine a child that was born in 2006, approaching 20, and she's been doing that job. If you notice when she was talking, the passion, she was almost in tears. In fact, I saw her acting like this. I don't know whether I was tired, but you know, when you have the passion for the job, you do it freely. That's why we employ everybody here. When you go, like you say, when you see something, say something. 2 days ago, I saw a big boy holding a little girl. They were walking on the road and the girl was crying. I said, come here, is this your brother? She said, yes. That was the first question I asked because I had to first of all confirm that she even knows who he is. For her to be crying that way, apparently maybe she didn't want to go to school. But I had to confirm if they were related in somewhat, so that we could start from there. Is this your brother? I don't know him. Then we know what to do from there. So when you see something, you say something. Thank you. So like what she mentioned, I'd like to also let you know that NATIP has inaugurated the Anti-Trafficking in Persons and Violence Against Persons Vanguard in Unity Schools, by starting from Unity Schools, because you say when they say how markets, that's where our market is. Like when you want to do radio jingles, you go to, when you're talking about human trafficking, please you can just tell me the radio station you would expect people to go to. You don't go to the one that they're speaking, this is the manual, no, you go to Wazobia, where they'll be breaking it down to the layman, the person in the community. He's hearing it, he's getting the message. Maybe with her advice, next year we plan on this is the first time we are doing a symposium. Thanks to Barista Amaka Ikedia. She gives a round of applause for our commander. As I mentioned earlier, we just do the road work and we sensitize within the areas that we can sensitize. But this year, we've pushed it a little further. We have the public enlightenment team. They go to the markets, they've been going to the markets. The last time they were at Malwan, Maltree, Aziz, the market. And then we have, I don't know if you heard, we have sensitizations in churches this Sunday. It's on the invitation, so maybe you could also join us there. We have sensitization in the mosque. And we try from time to time to go to schools. Schools are not here now because most schools have vacated for the year. So probably next year, we work towards doing an earlier program while schools are in session. We don't have to wait for this week. Since we've done the testing, the trial, and they said the trial will convince you. So with this, we know that subsequent years to come, we'll invite schools earlier. Even if we do it first week in July. July is the month against human trafficking. We'll just declare the whole of July. Nobody will hold us responsible because it is allowed. For the fact that it's on the 30th, we don't have to wait for 30th. So we'll go to the schools. We'll go more deeper. What we want to focus on now is to go to the riverine areas, the outskirts, because it can't be only Port Harcourt Metropolitan. We have to go to other parts of River State. Thank God, very soon, NATIP will have offices in all the 36 states in Nigeria. So with that, we should be able to. But like I said, we cannot do it alone. We appreciate Asoma, we appreciate Fida, Aula, our partners that work with us. You know, they bring cases, we take cases, and like you said, another issue is the time frame of, you know, you have a case, you have victims, you keep them for almost a year, they are going to court, they are coming, but by God's grace, we are still able to thank the justice
system. Like they said in the drama, Tampa mercy with justice. I know there is mercy and justice in it.
So just to chip in a few things in what
sorry to interrupt my commander. The River State Commander Barrister Wamata indicated she would like to contribute to what I have said.
Thank you. Just a little information. I want to appreciate all our stakeholders once again. They've been very wonderful in this fight, especially Rotary, Pida, Aula. They've really had a lot of referrals and cases that the agency has also gotten conviction. I just want to, you mentioned on the issue of clubs. So we have a good one because actually, you know, we have stakeholders, though this is like one of the stakeholders and we don't deny the fact. We actually started the Native Vanguard and the Big Club. So it started from the national headquarters and we are told to liaise with the Universal Basic Education and the Secondary Education Board. So which I myself, I made us time to go and visit the chairman and to the glory of God, they have approved our letters. So by next term, we will start work, you know, going to the state primary schools and secondary schools to inaugurate the clubs, that is TIP clubs. We already have it, the Vanguard in all the federal government colleges, which in Port Harcourt, every state, the native office there supervises. So we have it, FGDC Abuloma, we'll have in Lumokoro and we'll have in Ahoda. So every time we visit them, check upon them. We even have an active handbook. We can share it with you. So we already have those things existing. So by next term, we will move fully into inaugurating those clubs because our letters are ready. They called me the day before yesterday to come pick up our letters. So in time, we are hoping to get to the grassroots in terms of this organization. So once again, I wish to thank everybody. So
thank you very much, my commander. Thank you very much. If it is to help me learn how to approve my leave so I can rest after this event. Next on the program, we have photographs. Like I previously announced, I will ask that you kindly go downstairs. I think that we have a very beautiful weather. Those who are very nice in complexion like I will show you the photographs. So please, when you're going down, kindly go with your red card so we can kick out human trafficking from River State, Nigeria, West Africa, the world, the universe, the galaxy, and where else there are living beings. So please, kindly go downstairs. I will ask that those on the high tech go down first, then we'll follow suit. When we come back, we're not taking much of your time. It's just for the refreshments, closing remarks, both of them. And of course, as the law enforcement agency, we must round up with the national anthem. Thank you very much. Michael Jackson is leading with you, Black or White. Officers and men, please kindly lead our guests, our VIP guests, and our wonderful, beautiful guests downstairs to take photographs. Our partners, our ladies, both Ida, Aula, the Ministry of Women and Men, Ministry of Justice, our landlord. Prince Harry Women Initiative, Daughters of Charity, NAPCA, not forgetting. Our sponsor, Rotary Club of Port Harcourt Hospital Jam, and the Rotary Club of Health and Power. Thank you.
Are we good? Okay, let's go. Eyes on the camera, please. Let's go. Alright, should I go on? I'm the real one. I'm covering your face, man.
Bring it down. Bring it down, yes.
Okay. That's their face.
Thank you.
Yes.
Officers are men, not to depress command.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, go!
Yay!
be serious. I shout hip 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 hooray with that red there. Just raise it up. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Hip hip hip
hooray!
Wait to me, Timmy. You first did it.
Thank you.
professional. The reason why we are pushing it to the commander is we had five staff. So we can't answer as many men.
For years and all that. What happens in between? What of those that receive these organs? What happens to the citizen? What happens when they are going trial for up to 2 years? What happens to the process?
Good afternoon once again. On the issue of, no doubt, when it comes to prosecution, you usually have a delayed process. But of recent, to the glory of God, at least I can say the Federal High Court was started giving accelerated trial. I started a matter 2 months ago. We've closed our case, prosecution has closed. And by the time we come back from vacation, the defense will open their case. Despite the fact that the matter has to go through TWT, as there was a trial within trial, because the statement of the defendant was confessional. So they said it was gotten as a result of from the US and force was used, you know. The judge gave us day-to-day hearing. So they have actually started. I think there was one of the judges' conferences they attended, and this issue of the accelerated trial came about. The Federal High Court for example, they have started that. So a lot of our cases before have been accelerated. So they are trying to
build
that
already.
So
we will be having... In the meantime,
they
sealed.
Yes. Of course, yes. At the end of the trial, the issue is that when it comes to sealing, because I've done a matter that involved the process, the popular hotel there, we have to get an expert order to seal the premises pending investigation of the matter. So in the course of the investigation, we found that some of these properties are not being owned by the real, by the perpetrator. They are not the real owners. So that's the problem we have. You understand? And you found that once you go seal the premises, you know, the owners will come and tell you that they are not aware. They'll bring a motion of notice, and at the end of the day, find out that the cost is okay. So these are the issues we are having. So what we normally do this time, and the act has a provision for compensation of victims of trafficking. So when a trafficker is convicted, we insist, in fact, I've had a lot of matters that compensation, reasonable compensation, were granted to the victims of trafficking. So that's what now we do. But when we do asset case or the local asset case, and we find out that the trafficker has some assets gotten as a result of the proceeds of trafficking. Of course, at the end of the trial, you can bring down, you can bring a motion for that. You understand? Telling the court, facts are proof. Why not? It's not important for some of our donor commanders, every piece of property that are belonging, that are reasonably traced, not to trafficking. But for here, we are actually finding it difficult because some of the properties, a lot of them are red. That is why you see that once you go raid a place, by the time you're coming, like especially the baby factories, if you go raid a baby factory, and by the time you come back, you will not see anybody there. They will pack. The properties do not belong to them. I think these are now going a lot of places involving baby factories. So they are having their properties, and they don't use their properties because of the non-genuine things. So before you can get to them, they will move. So these are some of the challenges we are having in the past. Good afternoon. I'm trying to complain about different points. I'm wondering why would it be just because I'm not one of property of the field? If I'm a landlord, I should be aware of what I'm saying here. What's the barrel that now responsible for it should not be. They should not be given anything there at all. That's true. So, there's something to tell about that.
Yes.
Yeah, you're right. Because the truth of the matter is that we are sitting under the TID Act, Trafficking Investments Prohibition Enforcement and Prohibition Act. So now the Act is currently undergoing amendment that those people also lie. So, I don't know actually, probably before the year runs out, a new amendment should come up. Because a lot of things we do, we do carry the tear of that. So that's just the little challenge we are having, you know. So I'm sure on time it's going to be sorted out. In fact, it's already been sorted out. We're just waiting for the new work to come so that we start.
I'm not sure this part you have reached out to us because people deal from trafficking of persons, the Federal Act, with the facts of the case, can be an offense like attempted murder, where you have to arrest somebody's daughter. In fact, if you deem anything that would endanger somebody's life, and outside charging under, like it happens in university, outside charging under the provisions of the law that is applicable in Rivers State, the Ministry of Justice also have the fiat from the Federal Attorney General. So most of these federal offenses you can also charge. So and we have the family courts that deal with some of these offenses relating to children. So if there's any difficulty, if you bring a proposal, I'm sure we'll look into it and see how we can not just be a landlord, but also partner.
Yeah, I appreciate the fact.
Once again, I want to appreciate the Ministry of Justice. They've really been very, very helpful in fighting STIP. Usually it was DPP that needs to come around our programs. So I don't know why it's also not here. You have also been there because we have also attended a lot of programs together and he knows what we have actually been doing and giving us support, actually doing what we know. So, yes, even the last time we spoke, we are talking about the TIP matter. I came to the Ministry of Justice, we are trying to put them together on how to prosecute the matter. So we actually can partner, you know. But I think I would like the partnership to go further on this issue of the access. What maybe you look at the law under the state? Exactly. That for those, for that particular property, so that probably less if actually they can be confiscated. You know, and I believe it serve as a deterrent to landlord owners so that they can do due diligence when it comes to giving out properties. Yeah, but before then, I believe, hopefully, before the year runs out, the amendments will come, but we are still partners, and we will forever be partners. So thank you very much for that. Hello, taxi.
Bombs, in the villages.
So I can sink into the heart that this is really abnormal. It's offending. Right? When you see our children, who's going to be a child, take it abroad and give it to dogs, give it to animals. So that they can harvest it. But it's not something to be hard on. So please, this message should go down to the rural areas, because most of them are out of rural areas. Most of these rural areas have not had any abject poverty, so anything money can get them in. So please, reach out to those communities, villages, through their community leaders, organizations, enlightenment. I think you will look at the impact in this area. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Any other contributions, queries, questions? If we don't have any more, we would like to call on a very senior officer of the National Agency for the Prevention of Trafficking in Persons. No other person but by the name of Mr. Victor Odukutu, to kindly come forward and give us the closing remarks.
Thank you very much. A round of applause, please. Thank you, Mr. My name is Odukutu. I was an apprentice in NAPTI for 21 years, fight against human trafficking is not just for the government, it is for everybody. And the theme of this program is leave no child behind in the fight against human trafficking. The MC says everybody is a child. We need to leave no one behind in the fight against human trafficking. Vulnerable people are not just women and children. Men are equally vulnerable now. This is just what. And that dog's organ career, obviously. If that's my doctor, if you are 50 years old, you're going to be 50 years, you have a good heart, your organ can be taken. I have to give you a little time, but I don't want to add one of the things. We are operating. If you commit a crime or we are investigating the crime you committed, the crime of human trafficking, we are equally investigating your source of wealth so that we know where you get money. And that's how we come up with profiling. Know what you do and how you do your job. If it is established that the proceeds from which you have your assets comes from trafficking, the properties or whatever, your money will be confiscated and the money will be paid into trafficking trust fund. And that's where we get money to take care of victims of human trafficking. It's not just the government and concern or persons or individuals alone. They were telling the government to help us. I'm going to call the government, we're going to call it on all of us. If you look at the law, where you think you're going to be better, you make submissions or suggestions. If somebody commits a crime and the proceeds is not taken, he goes to prison after 5 years, 6 years, he comes back to a judge. Just like what the SEC does now, if you give a house to somebody and he's doing an illegal business, if the person is prosecuted, the property is going to resist. It becomes the government property. We only want the government to do it for us in London, so that together we can fight this fight. Once again, I thank you all for coming. Thank you for your support. And we want to call on you to assist us. Please, when we call on you, do well to answer us. We are just coming up like other organizations, through some of the other citizens organizations around here, but we work together. Please, if we call for assistance, always come to assist. Thank you very much. I wish you to continue to your destination. Thank you.
For
taking out your time to come. We say thank you very much. On behalf of my commander, Mr. Wamaka Ikeyashi, see, I'm blessed for good. I'm just flexing with Connect. Right, so I'd like to thank you all for coming. And we hope to see you at the church on Sunday and also for the road walk. Starting by 8 a.m. at Borough Park, Port Harcourt to River State Ministry of Justice, where an active office is located on the third floor. Am I giving this a road trip? Road trip. Actually, not the enemy. I think we're the enemy because I'm blending it. Thank you very much for coming. I appreciate you for your time. And we look forward to partnering with you. We look forward to getting reports from you. And we look forward to working hand in hand with you. Thank you and God bless you. Right, let me close this ceremony by introducing myself once again. I am Joy Arnold, NAPTI Principal Intelligence Officer, River State Command. Thank you. DJ, you have confused me with Bedu. Please, national anthem.